So let's look at what we want to. I want to talk about Elliot's five waves pattern. All right, now we have what we have something here. Now look at, if you look at the right hand side of the screen, right? Now this is actually how the wave looks like, right? So let's read out what they have to say here, then I'll do the explanation for us. Now, they said, Elliott's wave theory is a form of technical analysis that looks for recurrent long-term price pattern related to persistent, trust me. So this is, I'm looking for explanation that makes sense to us, because some of these people, they can know how to complicate issues. Anyways, it doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter. Let's look at this. Now look at this point here. Look at this. Now this wave now is mostly, is seen as more like a correctional move. Let's say for example, look at where my mouse is. This place, let's call this guy zero. Please just assume this place my mouse is to be zero. The reason why they call it five pattern, because if you look at this, it is numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this is assumed to be the uptrend. We also have the equivalent of this in the downtrend. Now this is mostly going to appear, this stuff now. Imagine if a market, right, was actually moving in an uptrend, overall uptrend. And suddenly the market came down. Right, market suddenly came down. Now this stuff, this Elliott wave is more like a correctional pattern to correct this before shooting back up again. Right, so this stuff you're seeing here, well, a market is coming down, like it was coming down here, and now got to this point and started making this move. Remember, most times market can come down, but it has not changed the overall trend of the market. The market is still going to be an uptrend market afterwards, right? So this guy comes here, picks up and move. So basically, you trade this guy in a short term. Now let's look at my trading view. Let's take this guy up a bit. Now, we have something like this. Now we have, let's assume market was moving like this. It was an uptrend, right? Let's say it was an uptrend. It got to this point. Why is my stuff hanging now? Come to this point, came down, right? And now start shooting back up again, right? It wants to correct this downtrend. It wants to correct it and move back up again, right? So what we're going to do here is that you're going to just watch what I'm about to do now. It's going to move from here, moves up, comes down here, moves back up again, come back here, move back up again. Now this is the fifth guy. Now this is zero. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, in a nutshell, I don't want to start writing with my mouse. It's going to stress me. So let's just manage. Now this is 0.0. This is 0.1. This is 0.2. This is 0.3. This is 0.4. And this is 0.5. Now, out of these five, we have three impulsive move or three push. Three push, That is impulsive and too correctional. Correctional is more like a pullback. Now, this guy, this place is a pullback. That's a pullback, guys. Now, the push is this long line, this place. This one, one, two, and three. Okay. Now, let me delete that stuff and take it again so that you see what I'm talking about here. So I come here, the market was coming down, right? When it got to this point, it should back up again. I'm going to observe this thing to check if I'm going to observe it. You want to see a market that was moving up before, right? A market was moving up, suddenly it started coming down, and it get to this point, it start going up again. You should actually be suspecting an Elliot wave pattern, right? So once you got, this is zero, this is one, this is the first impulsive move. There'll be a correction, right? This correction is always corrected to, I thought it was Fibonacci retracement, right? This first correction is mostly going to retrace to 61.8 Fibonacci. If you can remember when I thought us, those of us that just joined us, don't worry about what is Fibonacci. I'm going to explain it now. Now, how will I know that this guy is actually Elliott wave looking, looking like pattern? Once you notice something, this guy forming this pushback, this pullback, observe to see if it is going to hit the 61.8. All right, I'm going to show us it hits, it should back up. Come down again, should back up. Now, let's call this guy. This is zero. This is one. This is two. This is three. This is four. All right. Now, the five, that's why they call it Elliott wave five pattern. Now, if you look at what I typed here, so let's use this guy. Just 1 minute. It's loading. Let's check the image. Now look at this image now. Exactly what I showed us. The price starts from here. Right? This is a zero. It's here. We trace it to this point. Shoot. If you notice, this is the first impulsive move. This guy is the first one. This is the first one. And this is the second one. And this is the third. If you check it out, this is one, two, three, four, five. Once it gets to the five, the Elliott wave is complete, right? It is complete. Okay. Now, this stuff can now, if we start coming down again, we start another Elliott wave, kind of, depending on what we are going to see, kind of five Elliott wave pattern again. It starts from here, zero. Remember, this stuff was coming down. It came down, got to this point. Market started shooting up, right? This is the first push towards the upside. Now, this is actually the pullback, the retracement. The second push is always the longest. So if you enter the market here, right? If you enter the market here, you can actually take your profit here, depending. Because some persons will be like, okay, Where will I enter the market? You may not want to enter it because you're not really very sure. But the moment this stuff pushes up to this point and retraces to 61.8 FIB level, I'm going to show that in the chat. Oh, you'll actually be like, this already is looking like an Elliott wave. That means once it gets to two, the next thing is going to shoot from two to three. And this guy is always the longest. So imagine if you enter the market here, right? and then this stuff shoots up, you're going to be in a huge profit. All right. Now it comes back here again. This second retracement, if you noticed, the first retracement is longer than the second guy. This one is always going to be around 61.8 fib level. This second guy is always going to be 31.2 or 50% fib level. I've taught us Fibonacci retracement, and I actually set out three levels. We have the 50, the 61.61.8 or 618, and 31.2 and 50%. Now it pushes up here. They say price will always retrace to the end of the third wave. All right, so this guy pushes up here. It now, the next thing is going to do is going to come back down. Right, once it gets to this five, it must come down first. It's a must. It cannot keep going. It must get to a point where it will come down. Once it starts coming down and you pinpoint this five, that means your Elliott wave for this particular stuff is completed. Now let's switch back to the chart. Now, look at this. It was coming down. Click here, the first push, come down here. The second push, come down here, and now five. Remember I said this first retracement is supposed to be Fibonacci of 61.8. Now, how do you get your Fibonacci? Come to the left-hand side. The third item here, this is a third guy. You can see fib retracement. You tap it. Now bring it down. Put it here from where you have the zero, the lowest of this guy. Drag it to where you have the one. My drawing is mad, right? I drew this. I actually predicted this. But now look at this. The yellow line, if you look at the number at the side of that yellow line, is 61.8%. Right? Now, once I get 61.8%, it tells this. The yellow line, if you look at the number at the side of that yellow line, is 61.8%. Right? Now, once I get 61.8%, it tells me that, this guy is Elliott wave. Right? That means once it touches two, what is going to be the next thing? It must go up. So I'll come here and I'll buy. But in order for me to be a conservative trader, I don't want to be carrying my mind. I don't want to be so scared. This is what I'm going to do. Just watch out what I'm going to do now. I'll come here. I'll long from here. Normally, I'm supposed to drag this stuff to this point, three, because once it gets to this two, it must always get to three first. But I wouldn't want to put all my eggs in one basket. So what I'm going to do is that I'll first of all take profits here, because there are times where it might look like a Elliott wave, but it's not a Elliott wave. Right, it will just get to this point. Price will get to this point, right? Price will get to this point, and then the price will resist to go up. It will start coming down again. So you wouldn't want a situation whereby you put all your eggs in one basket, predicting that it's going to get up to this point. So instead, if you enter here, first, you notice this was a downtrend, something that was coming down, and suddenly it started moving up, right? All right, it was a downtrend, okay? And suddenly, it started moving up. So this is what you're going to do, class. Once you notice something like it was coming down, and boom. Sorry. The price started shooting up. The first thing you're going to do, once you start retracing, right? Bring your fib level. Just bring your Fibonacci. Put it at 0.0. Click it at 0.0. Drag it to 0.1, right? It means that if this price retraces from 1 down and hits the 61.8 or crosses the 61.8 a little, it has given you an idea that this guy is looking like Elliott wave. And once it touches 2, what is the next thing? It's shooting up to 3. right? So once I've seen something that is moving up and get to this point and start coming down, right, I'll say, okay, this guy came from a downtrend. Okay, this guy was a up, was an uptrend. The market was an uptrend before. It got to this point. It started coming down. All right. Immediately it got to this point. It started coming up. Oh, that means there's a possible Elliott wave here. Right. I'll actually put my feet here, drag it to this point, and check the retracement level. If the retracement touches this guy and starts shooting back up again, I'll say, oh, that is actually a nice time to buy. Right, that gives me an idea to buy. I'll bring my tools, my buy tools, put it here. Now, my profits, I'm supposed to take my profits here, guys. But I don't just want to behave as if I'm not wise, in the sense that market does not respect anybody, right? So first and foremost, let's be conservative. First, put it at this, put your first take profit here. Because why am I putting it here? I'm actually predicting that this place can act as, this point now can act as a resistance. This guy can act as a resistance to that market. So I don't want to, you know, predict that the market is going to get up here. Let me first of all be sure that it will pass this one first. So you put your small profit here. You put your trade here. The moment it gets to this point and you've locked that, then it kicks you out in profit. And you still notice that this guy is pushing up, you can enter the market again, knowing fully well that this second push is going to be very long since it's an Elliott wave. That is how people predict their market. And that's why people can stake a huge amount of money in a particular trade. Oh, they feel that this guy is going to. Now, let me tell you guys something. Market has a law of its own. Right, its movement reflects a structured formal pattern. Like market has a law, right? And that is a law that most times, once you master it, you make a little profit, even though it can actually twist a little. All right. So you notice that this guy retraces to this point, so you predict that it's going to shoot back up again. But you don't want to come and start putting all your eggs in one basket by predicting the profit to be here. It's first you take your profit at this point here. Just first take your profit here so that if anything should happen, you'll not be at loss. If this market should cross this point, you enter your trade again. Now, let's look at this in a real chart. Now, I'm going to do the opposite of this guy. Remember, it's the same thing. Opposite, whether it is the same or opposite. Now, this market was an uptrend market, right? It was an uptrend market, this guy. And suddenly, look at this. This guy was an uptrend. I can do this guy here because it's an uptrend that is changing to downtrend. Just forget about what was happening before. Check out the changing. It was coming up and then it started coming down. So imagine if I wanted to enter this trade here. And this is what I'm going to do, guys. I'll say, let me check my alert wave pattern if it's going to work. Just watch out and see how I'm going to do this stuff. Now, remember, alert wave starts from zero. Now, look at this. This market here. This is where the downtrend started, this red candle. So this is my zero. This point I just touched now is my zero. Remember, it's a downtrend. So it's going to be opposite of what I just explained now. So this is one. Come to this place. Right? Sorry, this is... Sorry, I've missed that. 1 minute. I've missed that. The numbering was wrong. Now, this second touch, this place is my zero. This place now. Now, this is my one. This is my one. And this is my two. Look at. This is my three. Remember I told us that two to three is always the longest. Now it pushes to four and come down. My Elliott wave has finished. Can you see that? Now imagine if I was opportune enough. Imagine coming to my chart and I see something like this. This is what I'm going to do. I'll come here. Imagine seeing this stuff starting here, right? I'll come here and put my fib. Let's check our fib. Remember I said this is your one. Then, so this is my zero here. This first point is my zero. This guy is my zero. Where is starting? This is my one. Is my two. Is my three. Is my four. And that's my five. Now, guys, look up. Look up. This market was coming up. Suddenly it got to this point and it started coming down. Let's put our fib level. This fib, come to the second guy. Now let me drag something. If you want to put your fib, come from the please come to this guy. Sorry. Take your fib, the third guy. If you tap it, that's your fib. Now, this is how it looks like. Look at the numbers. The yellow is 61.8. That's 618. Golden fib. That's what we call golden fib, right? This guy is actually 50, 38, and zero, right? So what you're going to do here is that you're going to start here. Come, we want to check if this guy is truly Elliott's wave. Although I can see it is already Elliott's wave, right? Now let's check this out. Bring your Fibonacci. Start it. Just take it to the top here. Tap it here. Drag it to this bottom. This bottom before the retracement. Now drag it out. Look at that very well. And tell me what you see. Now let's look at this. Hold on, sorry. If you look at that guy very well, you notice that. Please wait, wait. Let me delete all these things. This all these numbers is disturbing me. Sorry. Let me delete everything here. Now, put your fib here. I've noticed that this guy is actually my Elliott wave. So come here. Put it here. This guy, the highest high here, drag it to the low, and then remove. Class, look up. If you noticed, the retracement is around the yellow points, which is the yellow is 61.8. This market retraced to the 61.8. Obviously, once I see this, let me remove this part. Let me remove this part. Let's assume. Let's assume I entered into the market and I saw something like this. All right. What do I mean? There is an uptrend here that stopped here. And this red candle, a very, what do we call this guy? Bullish harami. Right? This candle here, this red took out two red green candle. This red took out these two green candle. Shows that the selling force is high. Right? Now this is what I'm going to do. I'll say, oh, this guy looks like he's as if he wants to go for downtrend. But let me check out my fib level to see if it's going to correspond to my Elliott wave. Come here, start here, drag it here. I can see that. So I can see that my yellow is actually at the retracement level. I mean, this guy shot down to this point and retraces and got to the FIB 61 point. It has a golden level. I'll say, okay, this market is looking like it will sell. So I'll come here. I'll say, I've seen a red candle. Two red candles. The first one took out this small one, and this red candle is still forming. Right? Remember, it's still forming because it has not closed. If you notice, it's still this red dot line is still on this red candle. It has not closed. Right? So I'm simply going to say this is a good time to sell. I'll come here, I enter my buy here. But remember, this point is seen as point zero in our Elliott wave. This is point zero, and this point one, and this is point two. Remember what I told us at point two to three. What you're expecting here is Elliott wave is come down here, tada, go up here. Tara, shoot. Tara, three. Come up. Shoot again. That's it. That's how the wave looks like. So let's number this guy. This is three, four. Okay, that is how it looks like. The one to two has completed. All right, so this is what I'm going to do. I'll say, okay, this looks like my Elliott wave is going to complete for the fact that the retracement got to this 61.8. So let me delete all of this and enter my cell, right? Now this is what I'll do, guys. Just follow me. Come here. I come here. Now, since this stuff has already entered, I could not catch it up here. I can just come and enter where I have the market. Right? Can just come here. We are still learning yet. We are not being conservative now. Now, let's say I'm predicting that this market is going to come down. Let's say we'll come somewhere here. My risk to reward is 2:1, 2:5. That means I'm risking 1 to make 2.5. All right, guys, look at this, how I've entered my market. Now, why am I predicting this? I'm saying that since it's an Elliott wave, it has come here. It has come here. I'm going to have something like this and then come back here and have something like this. Now, let's play back this stuff. Let's see what is going to happen. You come here, you play it back. Guys. Shit, I've canceled everything here. 1 minute. Let me take it back again. All right. Now, look at this. Look at the market. It has completed. Can you see that? It took me in, like, it knocked me out in profit. Why did, how? Because I noticed that this stuff is following my Elliott wave. So I just entered. Imagine if you understand Elliott wave, right? You understand the trend line pattern. At least if you master, you don't have to master 50 things. No, that too much of this thing can even cause you to make mistake. If it enters for you, you know that you go chop. Now look at this stuff now. This automatically has obeyed the Elliott wave. And look at, I missed out the market though. If I had entered the market at this point too, now let's check out the number of pips we would have made, right? Let me delete this stuff. Now let's check out the number of pips we would have made. Now look at this. If I had entered the market here, now let's say, I've made 78 pips clean. Like clean 78 pips. Please look at that very well. And look at it. Now imagine you had used one lot size, right? Let's say you use one lot size for this trade and gold gives more money. One lot size, let's say $10. 10 times 78, that's 780. Me, I don't close for the day. I know they trade again till the next day, right? So what I just want us to master, so it's left for you to go back home, right? Check your charts. I'm going to be taking it one by one for one, tomorrow, next tomorrow. I'll take another one again. Maybe I'll take us how to expand this guy. Now look at this point. This Elliot wave I've completed, right? It's completed here. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And five. It has completed here, guys. So if you look at this stuff, has started moving up again, right? Another Elliott wave. I can check to see if it is another Elliott wave because this one has completed. Downtrend has completed. An option have started again. So I'll check again to see if it's an Elliott wave, right? Now, so just give me 1 minute. Let me check something. Okay, so okay, this has confirmed my second guy. All right, so let's take it one after the other first. Let's understand this guy. Maybe tomorrow I'll expose us to something else in this same Elliott wave. Remember, the first pullback, that's, remember, we labeled it from 0 to 1, right? Now from 1 to 2. The pullback is always 2. 0 to 1 is always a shoot, a push, right? 0 to 1 is a push. Remember, they said it's a 5-wave pattern. 3 is push, 2 is correctional, or correctional or pullback. 0 to 1 is a push. 1 to 2 is a pullback. 2 to 3 is a push. 3 to 4 is a pullback. 4 to 5 is another push. Now, this is it. This is 0. This is 1. This is 2. This is 3. This is 4. And that's 5. Now look up. 1 to 2. Remember, Elliott wave is comprised of 5. It's a 5-wave pattern. We have 9 waves, huh? But the 5, both of them, they all be the same tech. They give the same technical impact. So the 5 is more popular, right? Now 0 to 1 is a push. 2 to 3 is a push. Four to five is a push. Three. One to two is a pullback, which is also known as correctional. Three to four is a pullback. Right? Now, the retracement of one to two. Retracement of one to two is always on the FIB of 61.8 FIB level. Right? It's always 61.8 FIB level. Now, why the second retracement, which is this 3 to 4, is always 31.8 or 50? It doesn't really get to 61.8. Now, this is what I mean. If you come here, bring your FIB, put it here, the highest high and the low here, and stretch it out. If you do this, you'll see that the retracement, this point number two, is close to 61.8% level. That gives you an idea that this guy is actually Elliott wave pattern. Now, the second pull, the first in Elliott wave, the first correction is always retracing to 61.8 FIB level, right? Now, the second retracement is always retracing to 50% or 31.2%. The first one, you might want to write this thing down. The first retracement for in Elliott wave is always 61.8. You can see it here. That is one to two. Remember, we have two retracement or two correction, one to two and three to four. Retracement of one to two is always 61.8 FIB level. This is it. Now let's look at the next one. Now how do I draw this guy? Now drag it from. This is where the move started. This down move, right? To where it stopped. And then check the correction here. So let's put this guy here. Now, if you look at this, this area, this is where the retracement is occurring. This is it. It's actually on the close to the 38.2. Right? Close to the 38.2. So that is actually how you act. But for me, I feel once you've seen the first one, once you've seen this first one, this second one, I didn't really pay much attention to that. I already know that this guy, once I see the first one, it's most likely going to go down. So you might want to ask why people give signals. They give signal when they have done the analysis, okay? Hello? Please let me call you back. Are they class now, Abby? Are they class? Let me finish class. I'll talk to you later, please. So here now, this guy, the second retracement is always around 38.2 or 50. It's never up. It's never on the 61.8. This is what we mean by the change. This is actually what we mean here. Where it got to before it changed direction. Remember, market does not move in a straight line. It moves in a wave pattern. That's why they call it Elliott wave. It moves in a wave pattern. And if you notice your wave pattern, wave move in a but at least I know I study physics, sure. Because at least I make it. So it's a sinusoidal. Thank you, sinusoidal. So wave actually moves in a sinusoidal pattern, right? So it does not move. So that's why they call it Elliott wave, right? So once you notice that, a market was an uptrend and it recently changed trend, you observe for Elliott wave. Now look at this. This Elliott wave has completed up to five here. There's a possibility of another Elliott wave here. Let's check it out. Now this is zero. This five is zero. Now this is one. This is two. This is three. I think so, yeah. This guy is three. This guy is four. This guy is five. You can see that. Look at this. This is more like another Elliott wave. Oh, I did not supposed to have come. So let's put our fib level. Let's put our fib level here, right? Let's put our fib level. Let's check something. I come here, I put my fib here, drag it up here. Let me check. Let me remove all this stuff so that. Let's move this guy. Let me delete all this stuff. All right, so this market started from here, shoot up from here, and then stopped here. Now this stuff is actually close to the as much as this guy, but it's still can still see 61.8 touching this last red because this was where this guy stopped before he started pushing up again. Right, so I will say, oh, from this point now. It can still obey the Elliott wave, right? So let me remove this guy. So this is my 0.0. Remember, it's always a five. It should stop up to this point. This is one. This is the first impulsive move, and this is the all right. This is two. It shoots up to the, this is the last point before it started coming down. Okay, no. Where did it get to? Get to this point. Okay, this is where it got to. Or is it here? Came down. Okay, got to this point. Got to this point. This is the point it came to before it started coming down. All right. So this is three, four, five guys. So this move from here, right? Got to this point, and then started shooting up again. So let's check this out. Please, I sent a material on candlestick. Please make sure you read candlestick. We've not even started candlestick. They don't, at least if I see it, I can interpret it. Now let's check our fib level. Remember, one to two is always a retracement. So where will I put my tools? I'll put it from this zero to one. It will give me the retracement level. We've already done that before now. All right. Now let's check out this guy. Let's check out this other retracement. Let me put it from here. Although this one doesn't really look as it's going to give me. So let's put it here. Let's drag it to this point. Let's drag it here. It's a bit high, but it's still closer. Now, the way this guy changed direction is closer to this 38.2, right? So you can see that it doesn't have to look so nice, like as if you're writing a technical drawing, but at least. So that at least give you an information that you need. Okay. These are three. If you look at this guy, the second retracement was close to 38.2. The first one was close to 61.8. So this goes a long way to still tell us that this guy is actually Elliott wave. So what is a summary of Elliott wave? It is a five pattern wave extension, right? That consists of three push and two correction. If you're lucky and then you catch it up at the first, remember, look at the way I numbered it. If you're lucky to catch it at point number one, right? And then enter, please, if you catch it at point number one, don't bother selling. Don't sell, right? Because it's definitely going to reverse. I don't sell, just observe it to see if it's going to touch two. Once it changes, now imagine if I was in this trade. Now let me show something. And then imagine if I was in this trade. Where is that my stuff again? Just 1 minute. Okay. Imagine if I was in this trade, for example. You enter this market and you cut the market at this point. Oh, this is not they do now. Okay. So imagine you enter the market and you call this here. This is what you're going to see. Okay, so this was an uptrend. Right, the market got to this point, started coming down, and this guy obeyed my Elliot wave. And then he got to point number five and changed direction. Another Elliot wave is about to begin. Okay, so this is one, this is two. I'll say, okay. So since this guy, I'll be very, very sure that this candle has completed though. I'll be very, very sure the candle has completed. For now, it has not completed because this stuff has not moved away from this candle. It has not moved away from the candle yet, right? So obviously, what is looking like, because the lowest point this guy got towards this place now, the lowest point this candle got towards this point, the top of these two, that was the lowest it got to, right? But the buyers pushed it up. That means buyers are trying to enter because this stuff, sellers entered on top of this candle and pushed it to this bottom. Right, but then buyers are trying to push it up again. That was why it left this place and came up. So me, I would say, okay, fine. I'll wait for another stuff to show, right? And then I'll come here, bring my FIB. Let me confirm if it's going to if this stuff is close to 61.8. I put it at this lowest and drag it to this point. Okay, you can see that this candle is actually on the 61.8. I'll say, okay. So because of this now, this looks like don't worry, I'll drop the material on the group chat. I'll drop it after this class. I'll drop it. The candlestick material. I have a lot in my phone. I have a lot. So I was even reading some last week. So I'll come here, I'll bring my buy. I feel like okay, this market is going to go up here, but I don't want to enter here. Let me enter here. Let me enter somewhere here. I'll come here, drag this point here. Now remember, if I'm doing normal trading, I will not just drag this in up. What I'm simply going to do is that I'll take it to this place, this previous. Remember, our Elliott wave, this is actually, this guy now was more like I'll use this guy as a resistance, right? But sometimes I might not decide to use this one. Let's use this one as a resistance first. So let's bring it down here. Let's use this guy as a resistance. Right now, definitely it's going to exceed this one, no? But I don't want to, I want to watch it exceed it first before I'll put another one. So once you get to this point and it touches this stuff and I take my profit, I'll move up again. But before I proceed, this is what I'm going to do. I'll say, okay, fine. I'm predicting that this market is going to go up. Why? Because from Elliott wave, it moved from 0 to 1, retraces around 61.8 FIB level. That's golden FIB level. Now it means that this guy is going to go up. Remember, market, this stuff has a law on its own. Don't say, what if it does not? Yeah, most times it can actually break it, right? But most of the time, market has a law. That is why people study markets, right? Market will never see anybody and change. So you study markets, understand how it moves so that you can follow it and make your profits. Right. So, okay, based on my understanding, I see like this guy get to this point is obviously going to go up. So if I'm not conserving, maybe I've already put my risk to reward and the amount of money I'm willing to risk, I'll take it up to this level. Yeah, let's see. Is that too long? The trade is moving now. Guys, can you see that? Can you see that the it locked me out in profit. It hit my take profit. Let's check this out. 78 pips. 78. Like multiply that by $10. That's 780 pips. Maybe if you had used five, If I had used 20 pips, that's 1,000 something. All right, so that is
1,400.
so you can see it. Me, I'm done for the day. For me, this is how I do my trading. Like, in case you guys are wondering, I don't spend too much time trading. Maybe in the night, I check out, I look at my trades, my charts. In the morning, I just turn my charts for like 30 minutes, 45 minutes. I'm done. I go and do other stuff, right? Like today, and I did not trade because I had a lot of things. Before I could come back from the gym, it's already late. So a lot of things, I just left it because I need to be very stable before I touch my chart. So if you want to trade, please do that in the morning when your mind is still right. Now, please, all these things we have been discussing, how do you master your trade? How do you become a professional in chart? You can be looking at charts, for 10 years. If you don't really have a principle that is guiding you or what you're looking out for in the chart, you will not make any progress. For example, right? What do I mean by something guiding you now? You've actually learned Elliot wave today. Why not just open your chart, backtest it, scroll backwards, and notice when and where Elliot wave happened, how it happened. You take note of it. Oh, that means I've noticed this guy. So anytime you see something like this again, you can just predict and then see what's most likely is going to turn out to be. If it clicked, oh, that means I understand this particular pattern now, right? So they say 90% of the times, if this thing happened like this, if I go like this, I'll make profit. You record it. You pick another one, trend line. You check it out, you record it. That is the only way, you become a professional. But if you keep on opening your chart and be looking at your chart left, right, center without pinpointing and know what you're checking out for, right? You're just going to waste your time. So please take this very, very serious. Don't just open your charts and be looking at it like you've not seen it before. For every chart you open, be objective about your charts. What exactly am I looking out for, right? Let me practice what has happened in the past so that if these things should happen in the future, I'll be able to say, okay, this is exactly what I'm expecting. That is how you become a professional. But if you open your charts and be looking at it as if you're watching TV, it doesn't make sense, right? So once you open your charts, if you understand candlestick pattern, that is also another thing that will help you, right? If once you start reading candlestick pattern, okay, that is what is going to make you spend so much time because this chart pattern, these ones now, they are chart pattern. Looking at how the chart is appearing, right? Now, but candlestick, right? If you now read, we have bullish, we have doji, we have hard.